With play-ins at Worlds being the most competitive they've ever been, we wanted to look back at some of the strategies teams used to get ahead. Specifically, we're going to go over the insane level 3 gank strategy that Peanut took advantage of to completely take control of the game. Make sure to stick around for a tier list of champions to use the strategy with and against. We're going to teach you how you can use it in your own solo queue to literally win the game within minutes, and break down every reason as to why it's good. So let's jump into it. If you asked most players what the fastest way to get level 3 in gank is, they'd probably tell you buff buff gromp or buff gromp buff, but that's just not true. While it's a route that is still really strong, and we see it a lot, there's actually a faster way, and that's what Peanut does in this game. He goes blue, gromp, and wolves, and then immediately looks for a gank onto mid lane from the same side. This results in Azir blowing flash and teleport to get back to lane after dying. This pretty much wins the early game for the entire team, but we'll get back to that later. You might be wondering how this is any different from a standard level 3 gank that doesn't do this pathing, but there are actually so many reasons why this gank is extremely good. First, it's by far the fastest level 3 in the game, meaning that unless the enemy jungler also does this exact same path, he'll still be on a camp when this gank happens, even if he does the next fastest of buff buff gromp. This means it's nearly impossible to counter this gank, and makes it very low risk and high reward. Second, it's extremely unexpected and hard to counter. Notice how Azir moves up to ward on his top side because he knows that Kindred started at blue. You rarely see players die to level 3 ganks at this level, and it's because jungle tracking is a huge part of the competitive aspect of the game. This is why you'll see a lot of 5 camp clears into Scuttlecrab from both junglers, because it's consistent and gets you level 4. Most junglers' first gank will occur on the opposite side from where they started, and this is why even at the highest level this gank still works. In solo queue, we're usually taught to expect the same thing, and you'll see a lot of players ward exactly where Azir did as well. This is when you can use this strategy to pick up a free kill. Third, even if your opponent knows about this strategy and wards the right side, you can just keep clearing up after wolves and then gank from top side. This pathing doesn't put you really far out of the way like a red to top cheese gank would, or mess up your camp cycling. You don't have to commit really hard to the play like other early game ganks force you to do. For example, if you were going to commit to a level 3 gank top by doing blue gromp red and it fails, you're going to be really behind the other jungler if they're just clearing up. You leave your wolves and raptors up, so almost none of your camps are respawning, and you're stuck topside with a really awkward 30 seconds to kill before crab spawns. We often talk about how having options and spending time efficiently as a jungler is by far the best thing in the entire game. We're not saying to do this strategy every game, but having it in your bag of tricks to pull from lets you adapt to your enemy even better. After all, having more options is never a bad thing. Finally, this gank just comes from the better side. Towers give vision, and because they're skewed to either side of the lane and not in the middle, they actually give different vision on both sides of the lane. Ganking from these sides means that the tower sees you much later. The vision radius roughly looks like this, meaning you can hide just behind the torch and show up completely unexpected. Giving the enemy less time to react to your gank is extremely critical, and increases the success rate by a lot. This also means that you can do this gank from both sides, not just on red side. As a bonus, you can cross through mid and still end up on the opposite side of the map to protect your topside camps, something that wouldn't happen if you were to do this strategy and instead gank bot. Even though the idea is similar, the enemy has a lot more counterplay in this scenario by taking your red or your topside. Now that we know why this gank works and what makes it so successful, let's talk about how it actually wins the game. Blowing the enemy mid flash this early on, as well as their TP, makes their lane almost unwinnable. With a double sum advantage, it's extremely easy to set up reganks or just force mid priority over and over. Because of this, Peanut is able to secure dragons at record pace throughout this entire game, resulting in the fastest dragon soul at Worlds thus far. Notice how Orianna has secured a pretty sizable CS lead at this point in the game. This difference is equal to 1 kill's worth of gold. Also note that there haven't been any more kills for LGD since the first gank, which means most of the lead and map control that they got was just off the back of this one gank at 240. A lead from mid jungle adds pressure to both side lanes because of threats of constant ganks and roams, and shuts down the enemy jungler from influencing the map. We all know how impactful Dragon Soul can be, but at 23 minutes into the game, it's suffocating. They haven't even taken the mid tower yet and now have complete control over the game. They go on to easily end and destroy R7 all off the back of just one gank. You may be saying to yourself, this is pro play, there's no way that my team would be able to do this kind of stomp in solo queue. But after skimming a few random solo queue games, we found the first one that this gank happened in and decided to show the results. In this game, the mid-jungle matchups are Kassadin versus Galio and Evelynn versus Lee Sin. Lee does this route we just saw Peanut do and immediately looks to gank mid lane. To no one's surprise, Kassadin dies and teleports back. Here's where we can start showing the difference between solo queue and competitive though. Galio dies a lot in this game, randomly getting caught in the enemy jungle, diving bot poorly and dying for it, taking a bad fight in the enemy jungle and dying, you get the point. However, execution aside, the fact that Galio even had the opportunity to move to these plays is because of the fact that the gank happened and forced a TP, meaning that Kassadin had almost zero pressure. Lee Sin still got ahead off the early play and was able to snowball himself early on, letting him carry some of the fights later into the game. We don't have to rely on teammates at all if we can just get ahead ourselves. That's what makes this gank so good for winning games. Even if your mid does a terrible job of taking advantage of the free lane, you get ahead too. Just like Peanut's game, Lee ends up securing the early dragons and puts a ton of pressure onto the enemy team. A lot of players struggle to close games versus hyperscaling champions like Kassadin and Azir. This gank is extremely good for these kinds of games where you really need to punish the enemy mid. Not only does it put them behind and delay their power spikes, but you get the snowball rolling and hopefully secure a dragon soul or just a big enough lead to win fights before they become a threat. Let's go over the champions that this route is strong against, as well as champions that perform well doing it. Obviously, Azir and Kassadin are really good to punish early, especially since Azir's mobility isn't unlocked until level 3. Getting a window for a gank before then is usually really difficult, and this is one of the only ways to do so. At the top of this list, we also want to add Talon, who needs to snowball and roam to be effective, and whose mobility post level 3 is very annoying to deal with. In the same vein, we can add Cassiopeia and Ryze as hyperscalers. To A tier, pretty much any immobile champion such as Twisted Fate, Ahri, Orianna, or Annie are all good targets. We don't want to put anything lower than B, since you can pretty much do this to any champion in the game. If they use their mobility, they're still a perfect gank target, so just make sure that you're watching for the lane, and you might be able to gank things even like Lucian, Fizz, Akali, or LeBlanc. If you see these kinds of champions get locked in, and you might want to go for this strategy, good picks would include Elise, Lee Sin, Kindred, Rek'Sai, Xin Zhao, and Graves. These champions all have multiple ways of getting onto a target and can respond easily to the opponent's flash. In the next tier, we have strong level 3 gankers, but the gank will likely not result in a kill. Things like Nunu, Hecarim, Nidalee, and Fiddle can definitely get a flash, but either lack the damage to follow up for a kill, or have one key ability that the enemy will dodge. We would advise you not to focus on this gank if you're playing other champions, but that doesn't necessarily mean that going for it is bad, just read the situation accordingly. Getting on map and doing something is the best way to win the game versus these kinds of champions, and what better than literally the fastest gank possible, targeted right at the source. We hope this video was helpful, and if you enjoyed the content, consider leaving some feedback in the comment section below. Let us know if there's any specific Worlds content you want us to make, and be sure to look forward to more videos as the 2020 Worlds Championship continues on. Thanks for watching, and until next time.